Hi, Chauncey. I'm here with Steve Harper, who will show you how he uses two head switches to send Morse code, to communicate, and to run his computer. Steve, I know you've been exchanging emails with Chauncey and have prepared a brief self-introduction. Chauncey suggested a minor change, and you had the idea that rather than edit ahead of time, you would do it now as a demonstration of how you use Morse code. What we just saw was Steve using his portable communication system, a MacBook Pro, which he operates by way of the Tandem Master Morse code device. Now Steve has changed his switch output from his laptop to his desktop machine. And now he's using Morse code to control the mouse. He's pulled up the email correspondence he had with Chauncey. He's selecting his text, and he just copied it into the clipboard. He went to Finder. Launched text edit. He pasted the text from the clipboard to text edit, and now he's going to edit the text. Now he's selected all the text, and he'll speak it.
Hi, I'm Steve Harper. I've used the Morse code for my communication system since 1979. I use my head switches for the dots and the dashes. I have severe cerebral palsy, which means that I have little control over my arms and legs. Chauncey, now ask away.
Now, let's go through the questions Chauncey sent. First, how did you get into Morse code?
This grant had 5 nonverbal children learning the Morse code as their communication.
So what your screen says is, in 1979, when I was 11, my speech therapist, Judy McDonald, heard about this grant at the University of Washington. This grant had 5 nonverbal children learning the Morse code as their communication. Wow, so you were 11. how long did it take you to learn to send Morse code? And then how long did it take you to be pretty good at it?
About 2 weeks to learn it and a year becoming pretty good.
Okay, so 2 weeks to learn it and then a year of practice to get really, really good at it. Well, how did you communicate before you were involved in the Morse code project?
Board and the other was a typewriter with a head wound, but mainly the communication board.
Okay. How much would you say Morse code improved your ability to communicate with other people?
100%, because with the Morse code it was all up to me to write this and then bring it to the attention to people instead of people struggling and guessing what I was trying to say on the communication board.
So 100% improvement. Wow. How important have computers been to your life and your communication?
They're everything. Without the computer, I wouldn't have a job. I couldn't talk independently. They're just everything.
I understand that you are a college graduate and that you have worked as a sports writer, a web designer, and a webmaster, and that you are something of a techno whiz with the computer. Did Morse code help you with all of these feats?
Yes. Simply put, the Morse code and the computer are everything to me.
Is there a question I didn't ask that you would have liked me to ask?
Yes. What's your URL?
Okay, so I should ask you, what's your URL?
http://www.syncfmu.com/index.html.
Okay, let me repeat that. It's stevamundo.com/index.html. Capital I for index.
I'd like to say, I highly recommend it and the master as a Morse code system to try at least. However, it's ultimately to the nonverbal people to choose their own communication board. After all, they are ones who has to do it.
Right. So you're recommending the tandem master as a Morse code input method, but reminding everyone it's up to the individual person to find or to decide what their input method is. What input method works best for that? Okay. Well, thank you.